Okay, so I was at this point in my tutorial when I realized that I had not turned on the video. So this is the exact moment when I realized that. Oh, it's recording now? Are you kidding me? So mad. Okay, so I have been doing this whole cake. And apparently I forgot to hit the record button. What I did, I decided instead of scraping the whole cake and starting from scratch, that I would go ahead and just show you how I got to this point by using a dummy. Here is my dummy cake, dummy for a dummy. And I'm just going to show you how I got to this point, and then I'll go on with the cake.
I'm making another video because it occurred to me that I hadn't explained how I could trace around these images on top of buttercream. What I used was an American buttercream, which is a crusting buttercream. It forms a light crust. I'll have the recipe below. And you'll see here where when you do use a toothpick, you can just set these images on top of here, and it doesn't go through your, mess up your icing after you've let it crust. So you want to let it sit for at least an hour before you start tracing over your images. I made a Batman video. If you haven't seen that video, I'll put a link in the description below. It explains exactly how I did this.
What I did, first of all, I printed off a picture of the Pip Boy, and then I traced over the top of the Pip Boy and cut that tracing out like that. And then I went ahead and traced over his body just like this. And then I traced over the thumb like this. Or actually I traced this thing and then I cut the thumb out. And I don't know why I did that. You didn't need to do that. Okay, so then I cut out his little decoration for his jumpsuit. I decided that I am going to trace over mine with a pen so that it'll be easier for you to see the outline. But what you would usually do is use a toothpick and you go around and you can, I don't know if you can see this.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start.
I'm gonna place my traced figure on this dummy. And I'm gonna go around the whole body, the whole outline. Now I have a little battery, so I'll be back. I'm going to finish up where I left off, the edge. Make sure I got it all, yep. I'm gonna want to take the outline of the Pip Boy. First of all, I did the whole picture, and then I cut out the Pip Boy and did him, and now we're going to do the details. So now I think I'm at the point where I can show you how to do the icing. First of all, you're going to want to make sure that you do what's going to be in the background. You'll do that first. And then what's going to be in the foreground is done last. So this is the background, and I'm going to do that first. You just outline the area. First of all, you outline it carefully. You want the edges to be as smooth as possible. And then you fill it in. Okay, so you take your offset spatula. You need a wet rag. And I did this so much better in the first video. Okay, so you need a wet rag and you make sure that your spatula is clean, clean, clean. You'll dip it in your water to clean it up. So okay, so what I do is I kind of just wipe off the front, but I need the bottom to have a little bit of water on it. And then you want to very lightly, this is such a light motion, and you very, very, very lightly, and this is what takes the practice. This is the touch that you have to just go around the edge of your, the edge of the area that you filled in and smooth it out. Okay, and you do that on all of the areas of red. This area, I'm going to use my pointed offset spatula because it's just a small area and I don't want to spread it out too much.
In my heart, I have but one desire.
Making sure that you're always cleaning off your spatula. What I do is I kind of let the water spill off of my the back of my spatula onto the area I want to smooth out. And then my spatula is wet and also the area that I want to smooth out is wet. And if it gets too wet, that's not good either. So like I say, it just takes a little bit of practice. It doesn't take too long to get it down though. So I see a little bit of water right here that has accumulated. You might not, the camera might not pick it up, but it will pick up the paper towel soaking it up. And the solution for that is to get a paper towel, because if you leave it there, when I put the blue on top of that, the colors will bleed into each other. And so my solution is just to get a paper towel and just go in there and you can see it soaking up the water. Just go around the edge. My icing starts to drag the other icing. That means that I have a dirty spatula and need to clean my spatula. I don't know if you can see that, but I'll show you. You can see I have some icing on the back of my spatula, so I make sure and get that wiped off. And then I dip it back in my water again. And I'm off to the races. This is a little more advanced tutorial. You might want to start out first with doing the polka dots. Kind of got the feel for how much pressure you have to use while you are smoothing it out, because that's kind of the hardest part about this whole method, is smoothing out your icing. But it's super easy. Just try it. It's way easier than what it looks. Doing painting with buttercream is for some reason actually easier than for me than painting with paint. I guess maybe because it's thicker and it's easier for me to control it, I guess. Also, people don't have as high of an expectation. For one thing, it's tasty buttercream. And the reason why we did that other part first is because this is going to be a little bit in the foreground, gives a little bit more dimension, and I want to get more there, or icing right there, just so it does kind of stick out a little bit. Kind of like your hand does. So you have this, and this is in the underneath this. This is in the foreground. Now I'm going to go and just kind of eyeball where the fingers are. And really, you don't have to put these fingers, you know, on top of here. It's going to still look cute because you can use the icing, the black icing, to kind of indicate fingers. And all they are is ovals, really. But I kind of like them to poke up a little bit just so it kind of just gives it that dimension. Okay, now I think I'm at the part of this video to where I can go back to my original. The only thing that I have left to do, make the eyes, nose, and mouth, and then go around the outline with black. This is my black bag fitted with the 3-tip. This is the part where you do want to take your time and make sure that you're getting your lines straight. I want to constantly be referring back to my picture.
I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Believe me, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.
I don't want to set the world on fire, honey. I love you too much. I just want to start a great big flame down in your heart. You see, way down inside of me, darling, I have only one desire.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe. See you next time.